I'm Sean White, and today we're meditating on seasonal affective disorder. Did you know that 5% of US adults get diagnosed with seasonal affective disorder? It's true. Additionally, 10 to 20% get diagnosed with a milder form known as the winter blues. Now, seasonal affective disorder is a type of depression that is triggered by the change in seasons, and it can affect your life by altering the way that you feel and think. Now, some of the problems that could come up is social withdrawal, problems with work or school, substance abuse, mental health issues such as anxiety or eating disorders, and in extreme cases, suicidal thoughts and behavior. So this is a very important topic, and this is why I wanted to talk to you guys about this today. So let's get started talking about seasonal affective disorder. Symptoms for fall, winter, seasonal affective disorder, and there is spring, summer, a seasonal affective disorder. We're not talking about that today though. But the symptoms for fall, winter, seasonal affective disorder usually start around late fall, early winter, right around the time that, you know, the days start getting shorter and there's less daylight, the nights start getting longer. Now, how do you know if you have seasonal affective disorder? Well, the diagnosis would be that you exhibit symptoms for at least two consecutive years and that these symptoms are a lot more frequent than they are at other times of the year. So what are the symptoms of seasonal affective disorder? Well, I mentioned the fact that this is a type of depression. So the first major one is going to be feeling sad or down, right? Also, losing interest in activities that you normally enjoy. Having low energy, feeling sluggish, that's going to be a big one. To that end, sleeping too much, if you find yourself sleeping way more than you normally do, that can be a sign. Overeating, which also may lead to weight gain, not being able to concentrate and focus on things as well as you normally do, feeling hopeless or worthless, and like I mentioned earlier, suicidal thoughts and behaviors. So these are all symptoms of seasonal affective disorder. Now, what causes seasonal affective disorder? Well, there's a couple of factors involved. And the first one I'm going to talk about is our circadian rhythms, right? This is known as our sleep cycles, but our circadian rhythms also regulate our mood, our sleep, and our hormones. So now when our circadian rhythms get thrown out of whack, you can see how this can impact all these different things, right? Our mood, our sleep, and our hormones. Now, when there starts being a lot more darkness, a lot less daylight, this can start throwing us off. Also, if you think about it, in the beginning of November, we had daylight savings time, the clock switched back. So that throws our bodies off as well. You know, it's like traveling, going through different time zones and stuff. So these are things that can throw off our circadian rhythms. Now, the other thing is a lack of sunshine, right? Now, this is going to be a couple of different reasons on this. So, as you probably are aware, sunshine helps the body produce vitamin D, right? So a lack of sunshine can cause a vitamin D deficiency. Now, vitamin D helps regulate our happy hormone, serotonin, right? Serotonin, besides regulating our mood, also helps regulate our sleep, our appetite, our digestion, our ability to learn, and our memory, right? So if we have a decrease in vitamin D, there's a strong chance we're going to have a decrease in our serotonin, and that's going to throw off a whole bunch of different body functions. Also, another interesting fact on a lack of sunshine is it may stimulate overproduction of melatonin. Now, melatonin is a hormone that helps regulate our sleep, and it is produced in the body during the dark hours of the day, and it stops producing it when it optically you know, observes daylight, right? So when there's more darkness, our body just may produce more melatonin than it normally does. Now, an excess of melatonin can make us feel sluggish and sleepy. So these are all things that can attribute to the cause of seasonal affective disorder. Now let's take a look at how we can manage it. So how can we manage our seasonal affective disorder symptoms? Well, there's a couple of things I'm gonna throw out there. The first one is more exposure to sunlight, right? We talked about that lack of sunshine being a big thing. So more exposure to sunlight is going to help regulate our melatonin a little bit better. It's also going to help increase our vitamin D production, which therefore is going to help increase our serotonin levels. Now, the flip side of that is, in the warmer months, when we're wearing less clothing, we have more exposure to the sun on our skin, all right? If we're wearing like t-shirts and shorts and whatnot. So at that time, we may only need 10 to 30 minutes a day of sun exposure for our body to produce the amount of vitamin D that we really need. Now, in the cooler months, in winter, we might be all bundled up. We might only have about 10% of our skin exposed to that sunlight, right? And it's usually just our face. So it's going to be a lot more time is going to be needed you know, during the colder months. So you really need to be mindful of that. So another thing that we can do is we can try exercising a little bit more, you know, being a little bit more active. Exercise has been shown to improve our mood and increase our serotonin levels. So this is going to be a good thing for us. Plus it's gonna help us, you know, get us moving, get us off the couch if we're feeling like sluggish, we're gonna feel better about ourselves. So if you can combine that with being outdoors, if possible, that'd be great. Going for a walk, taking the dog for a walk, or if you're going food shopping, just park a little bit further out in the parking lot and walk a little bit more. Try to combine things as much as possible, and that's really gonna help out a lot. Now, another thing is being mindful of what we're eating and how much we're eating. We talked about overeating being a problem, and that happens a lot. Whenever we're emotionally eating, then we tend to go towards comfort foods, right? And we tend to overeat comfort foods. So these are going to be foods that are going to be high in fat, high in calories, high in sugars. Right. If you go back, we've done videos on comfort foods. We've done videos on overeating. You can go back and watch those and get a lot more details on the topic. But just being mindful of what you're eating and trying to eat healthier, it's going to make you feel better, and it's going to help out a lot with your energy levels. So that's really going to be a good thing. Now, the next one, I'm a huge proponent of sleep routines. So creating a sleep routine in this time can be really, really helpful. We talk about our circadian rhythms getting thrown off. Creating a good sleep routine can help keep them on track. I run workshops on this. I love talking about sleep routines. If you ever want to do a workshop, just get in touch with me on that. I think it's really super helpful, especially around this time of year. And the last strategy I'm going to give you is, you know, interact more with people, right? Studies show that individuals that have strong social connections are happier, healthier, and live longer, right? So if you're feeling depressed, if you're feeling down, reach out to people. Let them know how you're feeling. Tell them, say, hey, listen, this is how I'm feeling. I don't need you to fix anything. I just want you to know. And you may find that there's other people around you that are feeling the same way. And you might create like this little support group for one another. You know, you may decide to get together more, go do things that you enjoy. Having somebody else really kind of helps out. It's a little bit of that, that accountability partner that I always like to talk about with clients. So that becomes a big thing. Now, if you find that all of these strategies aren't really doing anything, well, I would strongly recommend seeking professional help. Talk to your doctor, talk to a therapist. There are some treatments that are available that can help. Light therapy is a big one. Psychotherapy, antidepressant medications can be good. They may prescribe different supplements, like a vitamin D supplements. These are all things that can help you out. What we want to do is we want to make sure that if we're experiencing these symptoms, we're treating them properly, we're taking them seriously. We want to make sure that we're taking our health, you know, as seriously as we possibly can. Now, this one is very, 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 very important. If you or a loved one are experiencing suicidal thoughts or behavior, then get in touch with the 988 Suicide and Crisis Lifeline. Now, this is the rebranded version of the old National Suicide Prevention Hotline. It's simplified now. It's just 988. That's the only number. You can dial that, you can call it, you can text it. I think on their website they have a chat feature. But it's great. It offers 24/7 free and confidential help to those in distress. It also provides prevention and crisis resources for people, and as well as best practices for professionals in the United States. Now, this is the number if you're in the U.S. If you're outside of the United States, if you're watching this from another country, I'm going to provide a page from a link in the show notes to a page on the Psychology Today website. It's a great resource. It has the suicide prevention hotline numbers internationally, so worldwide. If you're looking for your country, it's going to be on that page. So if you're looking for a number, that's going to be a great resource. And like I said, I will have that in the show notes of this episode. Now, I hope that you found this very informative. If you are feeling symptoms, I hope this gives you a little, some resources, ways that you can start to try to manage it or get help if needed. I want you guys to be safe. I want you to be healthy. That's why we do these videos. So if you like this video, please click the like button. That helps with the algorithms of recommending this video out to other people. We want to try to get good positive messages out. So clicking the like button really helps out with that. If you want to hear more of what I got to say, then subscribe, turn on notifications, find out when new videos are coming out. And if you want, leave me some comments down below. I love to start a dialogue. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you ever find yourself experiencing either winter blues or seasonal affective disorder. Let me know. Leave me some comments down below. And until we speak again, be well, be safe, and be kind to everybody.